music is really nothing more than notes. And if you keep breaking it down, it's a note is a frequency, and a frequency is just a vibration.
Music is an energy, and we're energy. And so it affects us thoroughly.
Music is the international language. No matter where you go, it communicates in a very kind of a primal way.
I believe it's in our genetic code. I do believe that it's been passed down before written time through history. I'm sure we were making music before it was ever written down or even acknowledged. So it's been there, I'm sure, since day one.
It's a spectacular way of connecting with other human beings in a way that you really can't do any other way.
Music is built off of vibrations, and for some reason, when they resonate with our body, it creates emotion. And that's the miracle of music. That's the gift of music. Sometimes people walk around and they say they hear voices. And it makes them do certain things. For me, I hear sounds, and it makes me realize that I have to hunt for sounds that don't exist sometimes or figure out how to create them. And it's just something that hits me at any given time. I mean, I dream about it sometimes. I'll wake up in the middle of the night and then I have to figure out how to get it out of my body, out of my head, and onto a recording.
Yeah, I have an idea, and I think it'll be big.
I pretty much started banging on pots and pans in my mother's head since I was born. But I think it was at around 3 and a half, she was like, okay, you need to go take drum lessons because I'm really tired of you banging on everything in the house. So that's when I started to become a musician, in training.
Music has been my life since the beginning. I was playing on pots and pans. Before I could even probably walk and talk, I was banging on things. I was doing music, playing guitar. It's always been there.
For me, singing brings me to that peaceful place. When you get on stage and you're like two verses and a chorus in, it all just goes away. It's like you connect to the higher place.
Drums bring a huge energy to any music, and especially percussion. It's because you're using your hands, you immediately feel. When you strike the drum, you immediately feel that going through your body.
When I sit behind the drums, the pulse that is created, it's quite a thing. It's an uplifting thing. It's like flying through the air.
Guitar sound to me is like somebody having a conversation with you, talking with you. To have somebody have their own signature sound, I've always tried to strive for that, you know.
As a composer, as a person who just writes music, to write something and have someone else read it off a piece of paper and just bring it to life, it's really, really special and beautiful.
Performing my instrumentello at any time is a way of expressing myself. When I play it, I can feel the vibrations of the instrument all the time, my whole body. And that additionally gives me the sensation of creating the sound.
Sinner's Prayer is just about a person that has lived a really tough life, looking for refuge, looking for solace, and has just done so much wrong or feel that they have, that they're reflecting on their own soul, if it's intact or not, and are just looking for that last minute answer from their prayers, but knowing that for the things they've done in their life, heaven may be closed. Growing up in a place like Lawrence, even Time magazine at one point quoted Lawrence as the most violent city in America. It just kind of gives you a little bit of a snapshot of what that place was like.
In how many ways can you break my spirit down again?
I've seen a lot of my friends die. I've seen, people that I know, you know, from the streets, people that we hung out with. I've seen just a lot of people end up dead or in jail, pretty much. And I knew that I was heading down that same path. But luckily for me, music was my escape. I saved my ass more than once just by having music as my passion and as my outlet, and just wanting to practice all the time, wanting to be perfect, wanting to be better, and being inspired by other musicians and wanting to be, you know, in a band and those kind of things kept me away from being around those kind of people that were just not always doing the right thing. And some of those people now are no longer with us or in jail. And I know that I would have definitely been one of those people if I didn't have music as an outlet. Broken Road's one of those songs that's very, very, very vulnerable. I mean, if there was any song on this record that I've slit my wrists open and dumped it out on the table for, it was, you know, that song, and just about being in a situation and how I felt reflecting on that moment.
I don't know if I can say I've lived through everything, but I've walked this earth alone with bare feet broken in the snow. And my father said to me, it never seems to be, yeah, a simple walk down. I'll never know, but I've been told it's an icy cold, broken road.
I welcomed all these musicians into this project, not because they hadn't had their chance yet, but because they're great at what they do, and it's unfortunate they haven't been discovered to that level yet. And I'm glad that I chose people that people don't know, because when you put together a super group, it just really all kind of becomes about egos and individuality. And this was about the music, and we always wanted it to be about the music. Avalon was the first piece that I brought in with the members of this band. It really set the precedence for what this band's sound was going to be like.
A veil of sparkling white soothes and bathes me in the light.
As an artist, you're always up for something new and exciting, and our big plan was, let's get uncomfortable. Because sometimes when you're uncomfortable, you create magic.
Going to do a painting, generally you don't just do a painting. You know, you kind of sketch it out, you get an idea of what it's going to look like from the angles. That's kind of what we were doing. We were getting an idea of what Sully's vision was, trying to sketch it so that we could at least see where it was going to go.
Sully was like, well, I really want to do something with this beat. You know, here's a beat. And so then Tim's playing something, and I start playing something, and then all of a sudden it just became very organically, just started to like build itself.
You could feel the spiritual aspect of it, as far as that you would get almost like a mantra. It would just kind of get these cycling, just energy kind of going around.
I had the opportunity to use a lot of lyrics that were given to me by a lady that was really important to me. Her name's Lori Cabot, and she's the official witch of Salem. She just gave me a stack of poems one day, and one of them was called Avalon, and I was reading through it. It was such a beautiful poem about, you know, Avalon being the land of apples. It's where the witches believe they move on to when they pass away. They don't believe in heaven and hell. It's like this beautiful field of willow trees and wheat grass and apples, and, you know, it's just like a beautiful place to be. So the song really is about a meditation and the pictures that you paint while you're feeling these sensations and the warmthness and the lights and whatever it is that you feel when you're under a deep meditation.
We were trying to catch a vibe, a hypnotic vibe, that the music we were trying to create was something that would really take people on a journey.
If someone would say, what's the sound that defines you on this record, I would probably use Avalon as a reference. It's exactly what I wanted this band to sound like. And then through creating other pieces, it blossomed and it branched out from there.
It begins the album, and it begins to take you on this journey. You don't even know what it is.
Great to have that in the beginning of that. Ding, 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 ding. You know, like a little melody.
Oh, cool.
Ding, ding,
ding.
My Light was a great song for me personally, as far as how it developed.
The guitar player, Chris Lester, he came in with a tape full of ideas when we were starting to really say, okay, you know, the project's working, now we just need to get some ideas.
So I brought in probably 40, 45 ideas, snippets of music pieces.
He had these two different riffs, and they were in completely different songs, I even think, but I remember going that one and that one.
He took it home, and it spoke to him immediately, and he wrote the whole thing. Coming from Godsmack, Sully comes from a dark place a lot. That's what that music's about. And when he brought this piece and sang it to me, I was like, I just said to him, I'm so proud of you. You know, this is really beautiful.
It's beautiful melody, it's beautiful lyric content.
After we put it together, I just remember being in a place where my daughter was in my thoughts a lot. And then I realized, wow, what a tremendous journey I went on from who I used to be when I was this young punk to this place now where, like, I have this beautiful person in my life that has been so inspiring to me and has taken away my selfishness and has really made me reflect on my life.
Skylar was a huge growth spurt for him. I think it is for any man, you know, have a little girl come into your life, you see things differently.
No matter what I've went through, you know, most of the times I don't regret it. But again, seeing life through the eyes of a child and that innocence really makes me think, like, wow, if I could do it again, I'd do it your way. I will never put a ceiling over my head. I want to be able to create what I want, what I feel, and as long as it's true and honest and from a very, you know, organic place, then it never feels wrong to me. And ultimately, it doesn't really matter a lot of the times what people think, because I do this for myself. And I do this because this is a part of me as well. Godsmack is one side of me and Sully Erna is the other side of me. And I need both for balance. It's really important. Yeah, my light, you know, hopefully will be an inspiration around the world and that people will celebrate with.
It's really beautiful, but yet it really transcends anything. It's love. It's about unconditional love.
It's really refreshing to at least have a song out there that could be a really positive experience for everybody.
Under the light you shine on me, I promise I will be there for you, baby. I never want to leave you anyway. You become my life. Cross my heart, it's in your hands.
I want people to be able to translate these thoughts and these lyrics into their own personal lives. So I don't think it's really relevant what it is for me. I think it's just more important that people know that it's okay to be vulnerable and it's okay to express yourself, even if it means sometimes being a bit embarrassed, much better than keeping it inside.
Flames are turning away. Restless souls are crying to release them from the pain. They can take the pain. Thank you.
If I had to give anybody some advice on what to do in the music industry today, I would tell them what I usually tell people that ask me that question, which is just stay true to who you are and work really, really hard, but more importantly, be prepared for disappointment because it's gonna happen over and over again. You're gonna get that close and it's all gonna fall apart. And then you're gonna get that close again after years of work and something's gonna screw it up. But it's the people that have the determination to keep going and stand up again after people keep hitting them down and they fall to their knees. The people who can brace themselves and stand back up straight are the people that will eventually, their moment will line up. Like I told you before, it's a little bit of talent and a lot of luck. It's really important that people stay true to who they are and they don't ever give up, no matter how bad it gets.
The song that really comes together the best, I think, is The Rise.
It just made your eyes spiral and just it just put you in a trance. And we would just sit there for hours and just jam this rhythm. And then Lisa started coming up with some lyrics.
I wrote The Rise, and then Sully and I rewrote it a few times lyrically.
Just a metaphor for us as people in life. Again, for when life kicks you down, to learn how to stand back up and take a deep breath and reach down inside and find your strength.
It means that you can be on top and then fall to the bottom, and hopefully you can find your inner strength and rise above again.
Sully knows that if he's going to make great music, it's a team thing. It's not just himself. It's not just the Sully show. Here he is coming out with a solo record that he doesn't even sing on one of the songs. And that's ballsy for a solo record. And that's not the Sully that I knew 20 years ago.
What do you think?
I wouldn't have it all the time.
It like brings too much life for it to me. Like for me, my perception of this track is it feels very dark and hypnotic. The music eventually moves around the beat, but the beat never moves. Mm. We're all at an age in our lives, we're mature now, and there's a lot of discipline in this writing. Because sometimes we just hit a groove and it just becomes this hypnotic loop. It's just about hitting a rhythm and sticking with it for 6 minutes. That takes a lot of discipline.
He's gotta be in pain by now. That's hard to do. He's hating it right now. Good morning.
Holy f-
How'd that feel? Woo! Your arms awake yet?
How long is that song?
It's been like 6 minutes, 7 minutes.
It's good for you.
Yeah.
We Lisa Geyer is such an amazing singer, and she could do anything that I would ask of her because she has that kind of range. So I heard a different note, and I'm wondering if maybe you can go there. Feel the rise.
Feel the rise. Feel the rise.
She's always been this outstanding, phenomenal blues singer with a 4-octave range, just ridiculously good at what she does and natural from the heart. So we're really grateful to have her. She was a key element to this thing sounding the way it does. Maybe if it's this, maybe that mid-tone thing, and then ding, 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 ding,
yeah.
Ding.
Until then. Well, we had this idea. He was going to do it just piano, and oh, well, maybe we could have, you know, some, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. It was like the cello. Let's do the cello on it.
It was overwhelming to me. I remember sitting in the control room watching her play, and it made me fill up, literally cry when she first played Until Then in the studio. From the time she pulled that bow out and started sliding it across the strings, I couldn't even take a deep breath. It was like I was breathless.
Closest instrument to the human voice. It goes low but not too low. It goes high but not too high like a violin. Therefore, I think it's really in the range of the human voice. And I think that's the first thing that most people can relate to, even subconsciously.
And I can't go home alone again.
No, I feel like I'm this other character that constantly emphasizes on the words that Sully uses and kind of intertwines with his thoughts.
The melody that I used in the solo section on the piano was from the theme of the love story, and Chris Takedo came up with this beautiful counterpart for the cello solo that just worked against it beautifully.
I kind of wrote this part, and then Sully had his input on how it should go. And we printed it out and put it in front of her, and I, like, almost fell over.
I hope people can see music and hear it like I do and feel it like I do, because sometimes it just takes me over and I'm not even in the room anymore. I don't even know where I go.
The song 7 Years, such a powerful song. It's the epic long song on the album. So that's the one for me on that, 7 Years.
It was uncharted territory for me. I'd never crossed a path where I'd wrote a 9-minute epic song. And I even remember thinking, what the hell am I gonna write this song about? Like, it's 9 minutes long, oh my God.
It's actually one of my favorite songs. I always look forward to the next section, so it doesn't, it just goes by really very quickly, and it's a pleasure.
It's a journey. I mean, that one song in itself really takes you through a journey.
Both of us had just come out of a 7-year relationship. And so he goes, I think that we should call it 7 years, and I think that we should, you know, we're both coming from the same place here. We should write about that.
We all cross each other's paths, and we all have experiences through each other. And, you know, even in the times that we have to separate, it's all building memories for our life, to leave behind great memories and moments for other people to remember you by.
I think for any listener, when they hear lyrics that relate to their own life, maybe they can get over some situation faster, easier, just like medicine.
You and I could both listen to a song, and I could completely walk away with something different than you. Completely different than you. And I think that is one of the biggest beauties of music. It just transcends everything.
There's a million and one stories about people, how they say a certain song or a certain album or a certain artist saved their lives, you know what I mean? They were in a really, really bad place and they heard one song from a record and all of a sudden, bang.
The members in this band are just so sweet and pure and fun and honest, and everyone has this great character about them. And I really, really mean this from my heart. I had so much fun working with these people on this record. It was truly one of the best experiences I've ever had. I'm in a place in my life right now where I just feel content. It's not such a bad place to be because it's not this anymore. It's just this. Imagine your life without music, without anything to tap your foot to, or a rhythm or a melody. It's like we would be robots. I don't know what this world would look like and sound like without music.
The world without music? Man, that's a very dark kind of a thought, because I mean the world is a bit of a messed up place as it is, and I think music is one of the only things that lots of people have. Music has always been there for me, and hopefully it always will.
We take it for granted in some ways that it's always going to be there, or that music isn't that big of a deal, but when it's not there, you realize, wow, this is huge. This is almost like water or food. It's like, I need to have this in my life. It's always been there, and it's never failed me. It's as long as I'm true to it, it's true to me.
My life without music, oh, I'd be lost without it. That's a scary question. I hope I can play music for the rest of my life. But if the world went silent and I didn't have music, well, I'd still have it in my head.
Sometimes I don't even want to talk to people. I just want to sit and play. So it's kind of my own language.
I'm never happier than when I'm there in the moment playing, creating.
The thing I love about music is it can just totally bring you back to a place. I love that, how I can hear an album or a song and I can just be right back where I was when I first heard it.
It calms me down, it excites me, it makes me happy, it can make me sad. I consider it a gift and I cherish it.
It's my heartbeat to my existence. I mean, without music, I don't know what my life would be like without music. I don't know what anyone's life would be like without music. It's the soundtrack to our lives. I've seen a lot in a short amount of time I've been on this earth, and now I'm just really appreciating the people in my life, the support teams that surround me. I'm just ready to ride this out, you know, and just follow this right to the sunset and look back one day and sit on a beach with my daughter maybe on my lap and reflect on all the great memories I've had, because it's been a really amazing journey for me so far, and I just feel like it's just beginning, but I know one day it's going to have a really great ending.